श्री जय राम ओम श्री राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय 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 राम जय जय राम ओम राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हरि ओम टू एवरीबॉडी पापा हैज बीन trying his level best to make it clear to all of us, both the ultimate aim to be scaled and also he placed before us various methodologies. Naam, Seva, Dhyan and Samarpan. In order that we get more and more convinced about it, in order to ensure that the mind intellect operates and makes the journey successful, he places before us various perspectives on Nama, on Dhyana, on Seva. And finally, of course, he keeps on bringing the dimension of surrender. This should be in our mind while hearing, while attending. Otherwise, you know, it becomes a surface level activity. What we are going to read is also a wonderful theme given by Papa. Somebody puts a question to him. During meditation yesterday, I had a strange experience. When I started repeating the name, I felt I was entering a cave and the name was resounding and expanding. I felt then the opening of the cave was within my body and I was going farther and farther inside. Repeating the name, I could not see or be conscious of anything else. My body was so much stiffened that if anybody had touched me, I would have fallen down. During my meditation yesterday, I had a strange experience. When I started repeating the name, I felt I was entering a cave. And the name was resounding and expanding. I felt then the opening of the cave was within my body. And I was going farther and farther inside, repeating the name. I could not see or be conscious of anything else. My body was so much stiffened that if anybody had touched me, I would have fallen. Papa answers, that means you were not conscious of your body. You were just witnessing your body, standing apart from it. But did you find peace? Can you describe your condition when you were having that experience? I was so much immersed in the sound that nothing else attracted me. It kept on increasing in volume and I was absolutely lost in that. It was probably peace. I must say that for hours after the meditation, it kept on, less intensely. I felt at night also that something in me was happy, something else was unhappy, and it kept on recurring. Papa, so you had a pleasant experience. Did it give you quietness? It gave me moderate peace. Papa, in such states of emotion, we feel we are not the body, but something subtler than that. As we progress on the path, we have to pass through many stages. Sound is very easy for the mind to concentrate upon. As soon as the mind is absorbed in it, we rise higher into a state of super consciousness, where there is absolute soundlessness. It is said in the scriptures that Brahman revealed itself originally as sound. And the first sound was Om. Therefore, Om is the nearest symbol of God for helping the concentration of the mind and leading to the realization of Brahman. Om, the Shabda Brahman, is included in the mantra Om Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. The Brahman which is beyond sound, but which can be attained through sound, has manifested itself as the entire universe. The sound that you hear is what comes out of that infinite silence. This is highly subjective, so we must travel with the theme. The Brahman which is beyond sound, but which can be attained through the sound, has manifested itself as the entire universe. The sound that you hear is what comes out of that infinite silence. When we repeat the mantra aloud, we tune ourselves to the sound produced by it. And through the sound, we enter into the perfect stillness within us. So the sound must possess us. The sound is the first movement of the motionless. The method of approach through sound has been found to be the easiest. Some people worship fire, some worship various forms of God, some others worship sound, that is, they concentrate their mind on sound. As soon as the mind is absorbed in sound, the consciousness of the body is lost and we are drowned in an ocean of peace and bliss. Next time when you get this experience, you have to go beyond all form. Wonderful guidance for our inward journey. Ultimately, the vocal chanting should lead to what? Here he gives us a word picture as to how we should move forward. It is too subjective, so we cannot get help from anybody else. So we have to travel. We stop within words. We will again read. We started with meditation. During meditation yesterday, I had a strange experience. When I started repeating the name, I felt I was entering a cave and the name was resounding and expanding. Just like we read in Pujya Swamiji's, you know, the light of Atman was expanding and expanding, covering the whole universe, in which this body was also there. And then the next line of Pujya Swamiji was that made him realize that God cannot be located in this body. He is all pervading. Locate means in a particular place. When it is all pervading, how can we locate? So he says that was there only for a short time. But whenever he felt disturbed at the surface level, all that he had to do was to go to the source. Here it is put in a different way. Let us see what is in his mind and what Papa expects him to bring it out. No? When I started repeating the name, all of us are repeating the name, either vocally or silently or mentally. No? When I started repeating the name, I felt I was entering a cave and the name was resounding and expanding. I felt then the opening of the cave was within my body. and I was going farther and farther inside, repeating the name. I could not see or be conscious of anything else. My body was so much stiffened that if anybody had touched me, I would have fallen down. Papa answers, that means you are not conscious of your body, you are just witnessing your body, standing apart from it. But did you find peace? Can you describe your condition when you were having that experience? Here the important proof. Whatever disciplines initially we undertake, and when it drives us to a certain level of experience, our yardstick should always be whether it gives me peace. Not a sentimental or emotional satisfaction. An inexplicable pleasant feeling. Nobody can describe what is peace. But we know what is peace. Devotee, I was so much immersed in the sound that nothing else attracted me. It kept on increasing in volume and I was absolutely lost in that. It was probably peace. I must say that for hours after the meditation, it kept on. This is important. Whether it is temporal, transitory, impermanent, whether it whether it stays with us, you know, for a longer time. That is the yardstick. We remember once Pooja Swamiji was sharing one thought. When we go to a temple, when we decide to go to a temple, right from the moment we step out of our house and then walk towards the temple, our mind should be totally preoccupied with anything that is connected to the deity there, initially at the deity level and later on at the cosmic level. So that by the time we reach the temple, no, the mind is made conducive to become receptive to the vibrations coming from the darshan, preparing our to become receptive. Otherwise, it will be it will only serve as a surface level emotional or sentimental satisfaction. It will not be there. Immediately after that, you know, we will be restless. We just go there, look at it. Some puja or arati will be there. We will take prasad, do production, come back. No impact. Absolutely zero impact. That is why you remember in many of in good old days, our elders used to say, when you go to temple, you must sit for some time, you know, after taking the rounds, without talking to anybody. It is not merely sitting in that atmosphere. We are trying to consolidate our earnings. The same thing here, it says. I must say that for hours after the meditation, it kept on. Less intensity. I felt at night also that something in me was happy, something else was unhappy, and it kept on recurring. Papa. So you had a pleasant experience. Did it give you quietness? Yes, it gave me moderate peace. When he said moderate peace, the witness consciousness was there even for the mind alone. That's why you are able to say that. No? Very deep meditation, very deep meditation. And a clue to know how to chant the name, what the nama should ultimately enable me to reach. And let us see what Papa says. This is the most crucial point. In such states of emotion, we feel we are not the body, but something subtler than that. As we progress on the path, we have to pass through many stages. Sound is very easy for the mind to concentrate upon. As soon as the mind is absorbed in it means the sound. Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Ram. Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. As soon as the mind is absorbed in it, we rise higher into a state of super consciousness, where there is absolute soundlessness. It is said in the scriptures that Brahman revealed itself originally as sound, and the first sound was Om. Bhagavad Gita is that here. Om is the Ekakshara Brahma. The first was sound. Brahman revealed itself originally as sound. The first sound was Om. Therefore, Om is the nearest symbol of God for helping the concentration of the mind and leading to the realization of Brahman. Om, the Shabda Brahman, is included in the mantra Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. The Brahman which is beyond sound, but which can be attained through sound. Has manifested itself as the entire universe. The sound that you hear is what comes out of that infinite silence. The sound that you hear is what comes out of that infinite silence. When we repeat the mantra aloud, we tune ourselves to the sound produced by it. And through the sound, we enter into the perfect stillness within us. So when we repeat the mantra, all other activity of the mind is concentrated on the sound. And when all the activities are concentrated on the sound, sound becomes extinct. Everything comes to a stop, including the chanting activity. It is not that we are doing it, it is the outcome of the process. Today we taking PhD class. When we repeat the mantra aloud, we tune ourselves to the sound produced by it, and through the sound, we enter into the perfect stillness within us. So the sound must possess us. all of us are experiencing this. Probably not in this way, that's all. Why we say all of us are experiencing? That is why the urge is there to chant more and more. Somebody may be chanting vocally, somebody may be chanting silently. But the urge, I won't even say desire, the urge God gives us from within is because the sound has definitely helped us to taste that core of our being, even that we may not be aware. But that is the propelling thing, that is the motivating factor behind our taking up the chanting. Now we are trying to become aware of it, that's all. So now we are trying to ask ourselves, what is happening while I am doing the chanting? But in our Samadhi Mandir chanting, the only problem we may face is when we are doing a production, we may not be able to close our eyes and do it. So when we don't close our eyes and do it, unless the mind is so much concentrated, it is likely to get distracted. So by the time we try to bring in one point, some factor comes outside and the mind takes us outside. So this has to be, we have to be careful. But when we are sitting and hearing, this risk is covered, that's all. That is why we often share the experience we used to have in 68, yeah, when we were staying here. Mataji used to take us to the home and there, Papa Samadhi, where there would be no ritual, no nothing, you know, excepting one small chudi is placed on the holy feet of Papa. No other, no image. And so ladies will sit on one side, gents will sit on other side. Mataji will not talk anything there. So each one can develop one's own method of quietening the mind through mental chanting. Proportionate to the intensity, nobody will open their eyes. That is a rare moment we get in the ashram. So there is an intense concentration without even our knowing that we are doing an exercise like this. And then we try to hear our own chanting. And the witness consciousness develops, chanting stops, we get a glimpse into our original nature, the mind again comes, we again start chanting. So when we repeat the mantra aloud, we tune ourselves to the sound produced by it, and through the sound we enter into the perfect stillness within us. So the sound must possess us. The method of the sound is the first movement of the motionless. When we chant, the sound comes out, no? Whether it is vocal, whether it is silent, whether it is mental. So here he clearly gives us the clue that the sound is the first movement of the motionless. In other words, soundlessness, silence. Nishchala Tattvam.
Vocal and silent chanting do not reach silence unless you go with mental chanting. Mental chanting, you begin or what? No, that's all. That is automatically when you play with the vocal.
Each one has to find out for themselves. The sound is the first method and approach through sound have been found to be the easiest. Some people worship fire, some worship various forms of God, some others worship sound. That is, they concentrate their mind on sound. As soon as the mind is absorbed in sound, the consciousness of the body is lost and we are drowned in an ocean of peace and bliss. That is why very often Papa would suggest that it would be better to practice mental chant. Because when we chant mentally and we try to hear ourselves, there will be automatically 100% concentration, because otherwise you will not hear. Even vocal chanting and hearing, we can try that. But there also, whether it's with an open eye, whether it is possible, each one has to try. Normally, it will be difficult. When we say Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om, we should hear our own chanting. In other words, thoughts do not go out at all. The moment I don't hear this chanting, that means that thought has gone out. So when we close our eyes and then chant, the advantage is immediately you open your eye and restart. People who are computer friendly or laptop friendly know that when it doesn't behave, we restart, you know. Suppose you don't get the Wi-Fi, you don't get something, you know. Somebody, there is some updates, you know, you would have missed or overlooked. Ultimately, the system will not cooperate with us. So then somebody will come, consultant, or when we ask, you restart. Yes. Restart means the whole thing is, you know, comes afresh. So similarly, when the mind does not get concentrated on the sound, when it goes out, that means it goes out, immediately open our eyes, restart the process. By this explanation, Papa makes it very clear to us that ultimately how the sound should lead us to this state. So he is quoting from his experience. We have that portion of life. Here also he says in a simple way, so there is no complication. When we sit silently, we have to be conscious in the first place that the God we seek is in our own heart. So first step towards concentrating the mind. When we sit silently, we have to be conscious in the first place that the God we seek is in our own heart. Then mentally repeat His name. Make the mind repeat the name until all its waves cease and it becomes perfectly still. If it does not easily become still, we have to continue the repetition of the name mentally with an attitude of self-surrender. Please help me.
Whatever we do mentally, Ram Ram, it will not be silent. It is great as it is by surrendering. So it is great if you go automatically, natural control, we have to go.
First we mentally chant, we keep on chanting, we try to hear, then whether it is becoming still or not. proportionate to the grace poured on us, we might be able to get destiny. When it is not, He gives one more opportunity for us to pray to Him. It is not coming from outside. If the stillness is experienced, because He has blessed us. When we are not aware of the blessing, we have to plead for becoming aware of the blessing. It is purely an internal effort, absolutely internal. It can't be explained, but Papa has explained in a way that everybody can easily understand. Then, if it does not easily become still, you have to continue the repetition of the name mentally with an attitude of self-surrender. It can be through any method. You have motivated me to take this mental chanting, and then you make the mind restless. This is not fair. Like there's so many ways, you know. Each one can address this self-surrender in their own way. And then we try to develop a witness consciousness. So mental chanting will finally result in paving the way for the emerging of the witness consciousness. That means I am aware of my chanting. It is not the correct expression, but in order to capture the theme, we have to use this word. The chanter becomes aware of the chanting. That is witness consciousness. We develop a witness consciousness. This is a state of awareness of the immortal and radiant truth within us. In fact, this awareness itself is God realization. So how does this, you know, take us from stage to stage through chanting of His name to the core of our being? Through the sound, we transcend the sound. You remember now? Brahman, which is beyond sound, but which can be attained through sound. Throughout our day, we may not be able to. Throughout our chanting session, we may not be able to. But here, what is recommended is, no, we have no. At some point, some part of the day, preferably early in the morning, yeah, we try this method. These two, the sound is the first signal of motion. The sound is the first movement of the motion. So that means through the sound, we are, through the building, we come to know of the sight. Sight is an aberration, is something built on a site. But for the site, the building cannot come. Through the building, we are trying to understand the site. In the moment we become aware of the site, the building may not be there in our mind. Again, the building will come to our mind. Because suppose we have bought the site and we have built the house. On those days, you know, when we bought the site, we were thrilled by the sight. The sight was giving us a lot of charm. It has got made an imprint in our mind. It has taken a photo. What all we felt at the time of nearing the sight. Because it was a long ambition to have a sight first. In a proper place. And then we start the construction. When we start the construction, we are slowly start forgetting the sight. When we have completed the house, we have completely forgotten the sight. And then when they say, what a beautiful location, immediately we say, that is how we are prompted to buy this site. Again, we are connected to the site. So through the building, because the building has already come there. Through the building, we go to the site. Through the thought, through the sound, we go to the soundlessness. Sound can come only from a soundless base. Simple common sense answers this intellectually. But experientially it has to come, you know. This is the core of our being. Because finally he puts the seed, this awareness itself is God realization. So once again we will read, when we sit silently, we have to be conscious in the first place that the God we seek is in our own heart. Then mentally repeat his name. Make the mind repeat the name until all its waves cease and it becomes perfectly still. So when we should stop, we are not stopping. The process itself leads us to the stoppage. Because when we attune ourselves with the sound, slowly the sense of individuality is receding. From its grosser level to the subtler level to the subtlest level later. So then, mentally repeat his name. Make the mind repeat the name until all its waves cease and it becomes perfectly still. If it does not easily become still, you have to continue the repetition of the name mentally. With an attitude of self-surrender. We try to develop witness consciousness. This is a state of awareness of the immortal and radiant truth within us. In fact, this awareness itself is God realization. Again the question comes, why does it not become still? If during the non-chanting time, if the mind is rooted in me and mine, naturally it will become restless always. So there should be a coordination of what we do during the non-chanting time and the chanting time. Each one will employ one's own method. Umpty number of instances where Papa clearly mentioned, so long as the me and mine is there, this is not possible. How do we know? During the non-chanting time, he gives us various opportunities to test us. So if we are not leading a value-based life, moral, ethical, spiritual values, no? The mind will definitely become restless when we take this mental chanting. Other times we are conscious, no? The mind will be going here and there. So the toughest stage is mental chanting. Because you close your eyes and then you mentally chant. That means the sound is not there. The movement of your lip and tongue is not there. It is purely a mental exercise. Absolute concentration is necessary for it. That means that the mind has to be tutored, no? It has to be tamed, it has to be disciplined. So during our non-chanting, we start from that. During our non-chanting time, we try to lead the me to we attitude and we to him attitude as much as possible. Then we take to chanting of God's name, initially vocally, because straight away nobody will be able to do it mentally. Vocally we keep on chanting and habituate our mind to repeat the name And in order to gain consciousness, concentration, we try to hear our own chanting. That is one of the easiest methods to get ourselves concentrated upon the sound. To hear our own chanting. That means consciously chanting. No other thing comes when chanting takes place. So from vocal chanting, we try to graduate into mental chanting. And mental chanting, so first we start with our outer life. Along with that, chanting. Now we can understand why did you say Naam Seva Dhyan, no? Nama to remind us constantly, Seva to lead a value-based life, you know, spiritually value-based life. A life that is riveted to God consciousness, God dimension. That is called value-based life. Human values, social values, personal values, spiritual values, all are integrated in it. We try in our level best to live up to those values. And then the mind is prepared. And then we take to mental chanting. And the mental chanting slowly raises us according to Bhakta. Again we may get huddled. At that time Purna Sharanagati. And that is how he is leading us from the outer to the inner. Yes, that is why Naam Seva Dhyan. Touch of love in all that we do, in all that we think, in all that we talk. We may fail, we may forget, doesn't matter. But let us keep it, you know, as a discipline. If we are to feel that we are sufficiently progressing on the spiritual path, these are all the options given to us. It is for us to absorb this and try. Ultimately, it is God's will. But we must, you know, always we remember Papa's beautiful clarification on this. Self-effort is necessary till we feel, till we experience that everything is happening by it. Beyond that, we should not utter that word. Because when we utter that word, we are deceiving ourselves. So self-effort is given to us until we hand ourselves over to Him completely, lock, stock and barrel. Then we can say, Papa is making me to do, Papa is making me to talk. So unless and until then, we have to do the self-effort. Because that is the freedom He has given to know Him, to realize Him. If we don't make use of that freedom, we will not reach Him. Later on you will all remember, Papa says, you know, self-effort is to know that by your own effort you cannot attain. That's how we will be able to understand those meanings. At no point if we arrogate, if we cannot do it. But at the same time we have given us option, that is why we are chanting.
So the thing is, we
should not keep quiet until the handover. So through chanting, through bhajan, through contemplation, through satsang, through swadhyaya, you know, whatever method is possible. That is why various schemes are placed before us. It is all coming under the self-effort. In ashram also, right from morning till evening, is packed with a lot of activities, you know. Purpose is that unless and until if we don't make use of it, our mind will go hither and there. This is the self-effort we are putting in. to put a fence in our thoughts, words and actions, and so that everything is directed towards Him, towards Him, towards Him. And finally, when we know that all these things are not sufficient, then the mind really pleads its inability to go forward. This is a method where, you know, the jnana and bhakti is combined here.
Morning
would be, because the mind will be fresh. During the daytime, we interact with men and matters. Naturally, the baggage will be there, carrying over will be there, color and prejudices will be there. So the mind gets, you know, what you call it, disturbed, highly disturbed. So early morning, if we keep on trying it, it will be a wonderful thing, so that every time when we chant, we must be able to get, know that this sound comes from the my original sound is connecting me. Sajiva Tapa is the name, is the link between us and God. So hearing is guidance, we should try, you know, not really repeat. So finally he says, next time when you get this experience, you have to go beyond all forms. So don't get stuck with it here. And next one, of course, it doesn't lighter, but something for us to think about. So once somebody asked, this was in Switzerland, you know, in 1954 when he went to Switzerland, this was his talk. Just imagine all these things that come out during his Switzerland talk. As soon as the mind is absorbed in sound, the consciousness of the body is lost, and we are drowned in an ocean of peace and bliss. Swamiji, will you save me? Another question. Will you save me, Swamiji? Yes, what is the matter? Ramdas has come here to give you as much help as he can. What is your trouble? Question. The devotee. I was initiated by my guru, but he had not realized God. He is a disciple of so-and-so. He gave me initiation and is now staying far away. I have not been able to get proper guidance from him. Did you save me from him? Ramdas has no objection to give you guidance, but he feels it should be done with the knowledge and permission of your guru. If you can send a telegram to him and get his permission, Ramdas will be happy to help you. This should not be read in the normal, because otherwise we keep on shifting, you know. God has made me to get in touch with somebody and God initiated. I have forgotten that God has made me, I saw only somebody has initiated. But Papa is reminding, you ask his permission. He is also God. You know? He is not telling that. Next, I shall do so and come to you again as soon as I get a reply. You see, Swamiji, I am very much worried. I am a woman who has been working very hard all my life. I grow vegetables and sell them in the market. I have another woman to assist me, but somehow we do not pull on together. She does not like my way of devotion, and on that account I am greatly worried. I cannot get away from her now, nor can I send her away, as she is a cripple and will be helpless. Do you think your guru will have any objection to Ramdas giving you any guidance? So now, Papa is becoming sensitive, no? She needs somebody now on the field. She is placing herself. Just like Vinobaji said, you bear yourself out completely to the Lord, no? Nanda, do you think that your guru will give any objection? Devotee, no, not at all. In fact, he knows you well, had written to me to see you. He is standing. Oh, is that so? Then it's all right. What mantra did he give you? He gave me Hari Om Tatsa. Ramdas shall give you the same mantra. Here it is. Hari Om Tatsa. Now please repeat it as Ramdas does. Devotee, I am very happy. I feel a heavy load has been taken off by me. Same mantra was she was repeating. She found still some more hurdles. But when Papa did not give Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram, is that what is the mantra? Same thing. That is why between the lines we should keep on reading. Then so many lessons, you know. All are equal, all are sons of God. Nobody is inferior, nobody is superior. In equal measure. All those things he did not give a lecture. He simply asked his permission. Then later on he came to know it was he who directed him. Then he did not give a new name, new mantra. The same mantra was repeated. So it also clearly shows now how a God-realized saying reacts to different types of problems. You know. And immediately, as soon as she repeated, she says, I am very happy. I feel a heavy load has been taken off my head. So today, Papa chose to focus intensely on the inward journey. Let us all try to absorb, assimilate as much as we can. The joy we get while chanting aloud, we can continue. But at the same time, some time can be set apart for this experiment of mental chanting. Because then we are becoming closer and closer to the reality. Because by step he is taking us inside. It may not be possible throughout our waking state. So we will set apart some time for us, which is conducive for us. And along with whatever we are doing, we will also try this. And later on we will find whatever we are doing in the form of vocal chanting, it is a contributory factor for all of us. Not only to the chanter, but the hearer also. It creates the atmosphere also, no? Yesterday, when Satishji was singing, everybody felt that, no? Well, like that, it has got its own effect. But the thing is, it is not staying with us. So to stay with us, this is necessary, now we understand. We find joy in repeating, and as soon as it is over, something is there, no doubt. But in terms of spiritual progress, in terms of our moving towards Him, still we always feel we have miles to go. But this mental chanting helps us to move closer to Him and makes us feel, you know, we are moving closer, moving closer, moving closer. And probably He may bless us with a glimpse of His presence also during that. So these are all the things which we try to remember and pray for His continued blessings. So the Nama chanting finally purifies like the Katakana which we explained yesterday. And it percolates in our non-chanting time. Finally enables us to take the inward journey. And become one day. Nearness, with presence, with vision everywhere, becoming one with Him. These are the four steps He has suggested. Nearness we should feel first, then to feel His presence, then to see Him everywhere, and to finally become one with Him. Let all these thoughts occupy our mind space, so that while chanting, it will have its own positive impact. Hari Om. Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram 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 Om Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Hari Om, 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 Hari Om,